Hey, it's the middle of July and I'm doing a garden update. Let's see what we got here. I'm here in Arkansas. We're having the worst drought I've ever experienced. This tomato plant looks okay considering it's a drought. Let's give it some water. Got a cabbage plant growing as a volunteer there. Before I came out here, I checked the temperature gauge. It says it's 101 degrees out here. We haven't had rain in a while. What do we have down here? We have a couple of squash plants. Let's see if we have any squash that are ready to pick. Now here's one. Is this one ready? Here's a watermelon vine. It has a shady spot here. Here's a baby watermelon growing. Here are my cucumbers. And they're all dried up and dead. You can see here's the cucumber plant here. I gave up watering it. It was just, every day it looked like it was dying. Here's a baby watermelon. Looks like this watermelon is about ready to come inside. My outside water line is broken. I dug this hole up because I saw water spraying out of the ground. This pipe here is somehow broken. I'm not really sure why, but the water just sprays out of that black thing. And so now I have no easy way to water my garden until that gets fixed. And since we're experiencing probably the worst drought ever in Arkansas,
and farmers are dealing with the worst of it. Pop-up thunderstorms have provided some relief in Tennessee, Mississippi, and Arkansas, but it may be a little too late. In Arkansas, 69 of the state's 75 counties have been declared disasters, leaving people wondering if they'll be left high and dry at grocery stores.
I'm giving up on my garden, pretty much. I just can't take care of these plants anymore. It's just too hard. Here's my son's sunflower plant. It's a runt, but it did make a pretty sunflower. And now it's making seeds. Some green bean vines. Haven't seen a single green bean on it though. We might have some peppers ready to bring in the house. Let's see what we got here. Oh, that's not a pepper, that's a brown leaf. It's dead. And everything in this bed looks dead. My oregano looks dead. I water this okra plant every day and it just looks miserable out here. I was watering this whole garden bed every day until my outside water line broke. And now all my cucumbers and tomato plants are dead. I have strawberry plants struggling to stay alive here. I did water those today. I hand carried some water. Everything over there looks pretty bad. It's amazing when you don't have water for just a short amount of time in this heat. The water evaporates so fast out of the ground and the plants die. So this morning when I was looking at the garden, I was really depressed and sad, and I felt like I was fighting anger. I was trying not to be angry about this, but it makes me really depressed to see things die. I don't like to see life dying like this. And I see that if I'm having a hard time growing food, then people all around the world must be having a hard time growing food, or it must be more of a challenge than normal. And that means that there must be food shortages in the world, and I'm sorry about that. I will say though that even though I can't seem to grow any food right now in my garden, the weather is just awful. With the heat and the lack of good rain. And the pestilence too. I see bugs on the plants, animals stealing my tomatoes, like squirrels I think. Anyway, I just want to confess that I was feeling very negative today, seeing everything dead. But I had to step back and then count my blessings. What has God provided for me? Well, He's provided plenty of food for my family to eat, just not through my own garden. But we are having food to eat every day. We have clean water to drink. We do have electricity and air conditioning. And we do have good health for now. So I shouldn't complain. And I thank God for the blessings He's given me. And I guess it's just time for me to stop worrying about gardening and focus on spreading the good news about salvation. Focus on spreading the gospel for those people that don't know about Jesus Christ and don't know about His plan. It's all in the Holy Bible. And unfortunately, we as a society have overlooked the Bible for the most part, and we don't even understand it. A lot of us don't know what's coming next. We don't know that this is part of God's plan. I want to say sorry to God for complaining so much. I was just really down in the dumps about my garden dying. I hate to see it dying like that. But I am thankful that I have what I have. I have food, water, shelter, clothing, good health, and I have God. We all have God, and He's there for anybody who will call on Him. We should count our blessings each day. Yes, we have a lot of problems in this world, but there's also a lot of good still left. I think this is a good time for me to trust God. And it's a good time for everybody to put their faith into God and be peaceful and loving towards one another and help others when we can. Back inside, and it's 102 degrees in the shade here in Arkansas. So yeah, I do still have clean water to drink and cold water to drink too, so I'm thankful for that. Well, peace to everyone.